Okay, alright folks, welcome back to another video. We're looking at questions of quadratic questions where we got where the a value is 1. And the one we've done previously as well, we have no multiple, no coefficient of x squared. So when here, there's no number here, this is the technique that we're going to be using. Just refresh ourselves. We're looking for finding, trying to find two numbers that multiply to give you the last number, which is the c value in this case, and add up to give us the middle value, which here is minus 8, which is the b value. So that's the technique that we're going to be doing now. So we need to look at two numbers represented by these two shapes. The two numbers must multiply to give us the c value, which is 12, and they must add to give us the b value, which is minus 8. It's not 8. But how do we know it's minus 8? Because we look over here, the b is minus 8. Okay? Are we happy with that? We're looking for numbers that multiply to give us plus 12 and add it to minus 8. So, let's have a look. Okay. Now, how can we get a plus 12 and have negative answer when you add them? That means that both numbers must both be
negative.
So plus 12 can be made, Mr. Asaf, by minus 1 times by
minus
12. Because they multiply and give you plus number. When you add them, it gives you a big negative number.
Minus 2.
Minus 2 times by
6.
And minus 3 times by minus 4. Okay? So, we've written down only the negative factors here because negative times by negative gives us positive, and when you add up two negatives, it gives you a bigger negative number. Okay? Right. Okay, Mr. Zishan. All of these numbers multiplied give you plus 12, so the first condition will be met. Which one of these numbers, which one of these factor pairs gives us an addition sum of minus 8?
Minus 2, minus 6.
Excellent. So let's put them in here. Minus 2, minus 6. Okay, let's check this, Mr. Saf. Minus 2, add minus 6. Is it equal to minus 8? Yes or no? Fantastic. So both conditions are done. So what we do now, we just literally drop these numbers straight down into our brackets. So Mr. Ruiz, are you ready? So what goes here? Minus 2 and minus 6. So we have done the first part, which is the factorizing, and now we have to do the solving part. The solving part can be done in a bit more easier way. Rather than doing algebraically, x minus 2 equals naught, and then opposite minus 2 is add 2. Look at this here. An opposite of minus 2 is?
Plus 2.
Plus 2. Opposite of minus 6 is?
Plus 6.
Plus 6. Okay, this is as long as we don't have like a coefficient here, like a 2 or a 3 here. This technique can be like a quicker way of doing it. So we just do the opposite of us here. Opposite of minus 2 is plus 2, that's one of the solutions. Opposite of minus 6 is plus 6. Why? Because when you put plus 6 under here, plus 6 minus 6 is nothing. And nothing times by this value will be nothing. And so on. Okay? Happy with that? Right. Okay, folks, see you back in the next video, inshallah.